You are smarter than your mind. Your mind actually doesn't have one, a mind that is. If your mind was smart, it would only remind you of something when you could do something about it. You would only remember what you need to talk to somebody about when you are in direct communication with them. And you would also have immediately evident to you what you need to see or do when you're in that context. You wouldn't need a meeting agenda in front of you. You would know what you need to bring up with your board or your team in the appropriate order at that time. You wouldn't even need a calendar or diary to remind you of where you need to be when and with whom. Come on, fess up. Do you have any appliances or tech tools with dead batteries or light fixtures that need new bulbs or squeaking hinges that need WD-40? Okay, so when does your mind remind you that you need batteries or a new light bulb? At the dead ones. Gee, that's smart. Well, if your mind had a mind, it wouldn't bother you at the dead ones, but would clearly let you know only when you were in a store that had the appropriate live ones to purchase. Have you ever changed your mind? Sure. Well, who did that? That's the part of us that has to take charge and realize that just because we think of something that we would, could, maybe do something about, that doesn't mean that we are being productive or constructive about or with it, or that it will be fulfilled, or that it would relieve our mind of its source of incessant pressures created by our external and internal commitments. We have to realize that the thought itself is just a beginning, and if we care at all that it bring value or improvement or manifestation, we probably need to capture it, clarify what it means to us, and organize the actions and information embedded or associated with it. Your mind will seduce you easily. When you have a thought about something you want or should do, it usually seems so simple and so obvious when you're thinking of it, you'll never forget it, or that you'll remember it in the right moment. Then, 2 minutes later, with the next thing on your mind you're sure you'll never forget, you've forgotten that you've forgotten the first thing. And you're not reminded about it at the right time and context to actually get it done. You're reminded usually when there's something you should have done beforehand, or you're waked up at 3 o'clock in the morning about something that you just filed in there in that amorphous place. Your mind is an incredible servant, but it's a terrible master. And most people I meet, though, are still letting their mind run the show. They need to learn that a flashlight with dead batteries should either have the batteries replaced the moment they notice it, or the flashlight itself should go right into the in-basket, which, assuming you process your in-basket, will clear your mind's incessant attention about that thing, accessing the reminders at the right time and place. You know, you have to realize that you are smarter than your mind, and it must be tamed. As the ancient Roman poet and thinker Horace said, "Rule your mind, or it will rule you."